Alright, what is going on guys? Paul James here. Welcome back to another YouTube video today. Today, we've got a really exciting topic to talk about that I know a lot of you guys are really going to enjoy, and that is how to start an online business. And if you don't have an online business yet, or if you do have some sort of existing business, that's okay too, because I'm just gonna share with you how, in general, you can grow an online business from scratch, or you can take a brick and mortar business, if you have one of those, and transition it into online. Because as we know, more and more of the future is going online, so you definitely want to go and take advantage of that market share. Now, just like brick and mortar businesses, when it comes to online businesses, there's essentially two different types of online businesses that you can start, if we break it down to the very basics. And that is, you can start a service-based online business, or you can start a product-based online business. Now, with service-based online businesses, we're talking about things like where you provide services for people. So these could be things like marketing, web design services, graphic design services. When it comes to product type business online, similar to as in a store, instead of providing a service as your main thing that you're selling, you're going to provide a product that gets sent out to the customer. So this could be like t-shirts, or it could be like face cream or something like that. Now, in this video, we're going to be focused on building an online business around the product aspect of the online businesses. So we're gonna talk about selling products and getting set up with that. Now, a product-based online business is perfect to talk about right now, because right now you can go on Alibaba.com, and through the end of March, they have what's called a March Expo going on. And what that means for you is that there is going to be tons and tons of products to choose from. One of the things that I really like about it is they have this new trend hunter that's going to allow you to go through and look at trending products. Now, some of the major benefits of actually participating in this right now is that new buyers will enjoy free shipping on their first order. They'll get guaranteed on-time delivery, and also door-to-door delivery with customs and import duties will be included, which is just awesome. So we'll get into more details about how to source a product further in the video, but I just wanted to cover this briefly of some of the benefits of why we're gonna talk about products in this video today. All right, so let's talk about the framework that we're going to use in order to get this online business launched successfully. So the first thing we're gonna need to do is we're going to need to determine an audience that we're going to serve for our product-based online business. So this is a group of people that we're going to cater our products to. And if you already have a brick and mortar business, this is great because you already then have this part covered. And we'll kind of dive into that more in detail, but this is the first starting point, is you really wanna decide this and narrow this down, because this is kind of the foundation to everything. So from that point, what we'll do is we're going to actually decide on a product. So I'll just put product. And specifically during this phase, we're also going to source a product. And that's where Alibaba.com comes in, because we'll find a product and we'll source the product. And then from that point, that brings us to our last phase, which is the phase where obviously we start making some money from our online business, and we list it on our website and we launch our product. Now, this phase is honestly the easiest phase, because when you do these two phases right, it makes the final phase, the first phase, very, very easy. Okay, so the first thing we need to do is we need to decide on our audience. So in this example, I'm gonna use the audience for the sake of a brick and mortar business. And in fact, I think we'll niche down even a little bit further, because I know that there's probably a lot of people watching this who maybe don't have a storefront, but you still are sort of a brick and mortar business. Like, for example, let's just say a personal trainer, right? That's a business where you don't really need a brick and mortar business. I mean, you could basically go to the gym and train your customers there, and you are sort of this one person who is running this business and you wanna scale into online. The cons of sticking to this business where you're a personal trainer and you're training people is there's only so much to go around, right? You're essentially trading your time for dollars. So if you're a personal trainer, every time you train someone, you make money. And you wanna make more money, well, of course, you're gonna end up training more people, right? That's the way this model works. But the problem is eventually there's only so many hours in the day, right? There's only so many hours, and once the clock runs out, you've put in your 8 to 10 hours, well, then of course the money stops, because there's only one of you.
And the only way to scale would be, I guess, if you wanted to hire more personal trainers, you could scale that way. But this model essentially stops working. So the way we can correct this is we can essentially bring this model to online and run an online business with this model. So let me explain how that would look like and how that would work. Okay, so for illustration purposes, we're gonna call this offline to online. So you still continue your offline business of personal training and you work with people, you train them, you get paid, but we're gonna add a new component into this. And that is something we call cross-selling. Okay, now cross-selling is how we bring people who are already in our offline business, the people we're training, over to our online business. And the way we might do that is we find a complementary product that we could sell. Like maybe we sell, this is a really bad looking t-shirt, but maybe we sell fitness clothes for people who are working out. So this is something that while we're at the gym and we're training our clientele, we could be like, hey, go check out my website. I also sell workout clothes. And you're essentially solving another problem, offering another thing that they can buy. And this is a way to start growing the online business. And many times what ends up happening is that this online business will actually overtake it and get even bigger and may become your sole focus. But you can start to see how this could add up if you start meeting with, I don't know, maybe like three people and two out of the three people decide to go to your website and buy your online fitness workout apparel. Well, then you start to make money in both places and eventually it might just take off online. Okay, so the next step is now that we've got our audience and we know how we're going to grow the online business, we need to find a product to source, and that's where Alibaba.com comes in. Okay, so as I mentioned earlier, Alibaba.com has this March Expo going on right now, and specifically, there's this elite partner event going on, and if you check it out, this includes verified suppliers, so they've gone through authentication. These are suppliers that have an overall rating of 4.81. They have fast shipping times, fast response times, and over 5 years experience on these selected elite partners. So I'm just scrolling through here and already I see something that kind of fits what we were talking about, which is this whole fitness brand, right? So we could come in here and we could find clothes that are specifically like workout clothes. So let me pull open this one over here and take a look at it. So this one has their copper shield, and you can see it's the copper shield fabric is copper ion infused technology, antimicrobial, anti-odor, 99.9% effective. So this would be perfect for like a fitness brand. You can also see self-sanitizing, 15 days laundry free. They really do have everything. I mean, like look at here, they have this same copper technology actually for socks. So these socks, I guess, have like the exact same technology. Kind of an interesting product that could also be a hot seller. I mean, I personally couldn't imagine wearing the same pair of socks for 2 weeks. One day is enough for me. Leave a comment below. Let me know how long you've had the same socks on for. Anyways, you get my point, right? All jokes aside, you get what I'm saying here is that you can come in here and you can find a product that is going to work. And you can go and chat and find out how much it's gonna cost to actually get this in a mass scale, and then you can go and add it on your website. So this is what you wanna look for. You wanna go in here and see, you know, how much you can get these products for, and then of course you're going to go and add them on your website. This is going to allow you to start your own fitness brand that you're gonna be able to scale up and have people who now are going from just being trained by you to essentially have your online store and have a fitness brand, an apparel company for selling clothes for working out or for hiking or for whatever it is that you might decide. So now all that's left to do in this whole framework that I've given you is simply go and add the product to your website. And there's a lot of options out there for this. I recommend if you want like more of a free low cost option, just use WordPress with the WooCommerce plugin. That will get you a simple e-com store that you can set live and you can put your products up there and you can start having people come to your website and you're building your online business and they're buying your products. And this is something now that you're actually able to go and scale up.
All right, so now you know everything you need to know to go and successfully launch your online business or take your brick and mortar business and actually get it going online as well. We talked about everything. We talked about using Alibaba.com to source your products. We talked about their elite partner event that's going on right now and how you can go and get access to great deals there and vetted partners that you can go and source your products to. We also talked about the framework to actually getting this going, which is picking an audience you're gonna serve, sourcing the product, and then actually launching the product on your website. We talked about the importance of switching to this kind of model so that you're not trading your time for dollars, and instead you can actually scale easier. I hope that you enjoyed this video. If you did, I'm gonna put another video on the screen. If you wanna check it out, go check it out. I think you'll enjoy it as well. And if you're not subscribed to the channel yet, please subscribe, tick the bell notification icon, because you're not gonna wanna miss the next video that I'll be releasing in a few days here, and smash a like on this video for me as well. All right, so I will see you next time. I am Paul James. Thanks so much for stopping by. Peace out.